In this episode, I'd like to show you how to emulate older systems on your Mac, and why you should even care. For this video, I'm going to be using an old Mac Mini G4 system from 2005. It's only a 1.2 GHz model with 1 GB of RAM.
So the reason I'm using such an old computer is I kind of want to drive home the point that you really don't need a particularly powerful system to do any of the things that I'm about to show you.
Believe it or not, I actually have a fairly large collection of old vintage computers. Unfortunately, they don't all work. Take this Apple IIe for example. The disk drive no longer works, so all I can really do is write programs in BASIC. But there's a reason I haven't bothered to get it repaired. That's because I can run all of that software on a modern computer using a program called Virtual 2. This program is fantastically easy to use. Here I am playing Ultima 4, the Apple II version, on my Mac. And here's Dexter, another popular game from the 1980s. I love using this retro game controller I bought. It looks exactly like the Nintendo controller, but it plugs into USB. I can use a program called Nestopia to play all of the old Nintendo games. Here's Super Mario Bros. 2. When played in full screen mode, it's just like the real thing. Metroid was another popular game for the NES. I actually own an old Macintosh Plus. Unfortunately, it doesn't work either. I've replaced most of the capacitors on the board and resoldered all of the joints, but unfortunately, I only get this when I turn the machine on. Not to fear, I can run all of that old software in a great little program called Mini VMac. You can run it in windowed or full screen. Here's SimCity, a popular game from the 1980s. Or how about Space Quest 2? Of course, the king of computers in the 1980s was the Amiga 500, or at least that's how I remember it. There's some pretty fantastic games you can play using a program called EUAE, which stands for Universal Amiga Emulator. Unfortunately, this one is sort of a pain to set up, and for some reason it runs very slowly in a window, but it seems to run really fast using full screen. And here's a game everybody should be familiar with, Lemmings. If this isn't to your taste, you could play something like Lotus Turbo Challenge. It's hard to forget the good old Commodore 64. On a G3 or G4 system, you'd probably want to use Power 64. If you have a newer Intel machine, you'd probably want to use V.I.C.E, or the versatile Commodore emulator. V.I.C.E will actually emulate a lot more than a C64. It'll also do the VIC-20, the Commodore PET, the Plus 4, the Commodore 128, and more. One of my favorite games was Spy vs. Spy. Another popular game was Ghosts and Goblins. So what about another console, the Nintendo Game Boy? For this, you'd want Boycott or Visual Boy Advanced. It can emulate the original Game Boy games like Super Mario Land. It can also do color games like Tetris DX. Of course, we can't talk about consoles without mentioning the Atari 2600. For this, you need a program called Stella. It's very user-friendly and works really well. Here's Pitfall, a popular game from the early 1980s. Or if that doesn't suit you, how about Q-Bert? Or Pole Position? If you were an IBM PC user of the 1980s, then what you need is DOSBOX. Populous was always one of my favorites. In many ways, I consider it to be one of the first real-time strategy games. How about Space Quest 3? I really miss these funny graphical adventure games. I'm not sure why they fell out of favor. I really enjoyed exploring and trying to solve the mysteries. I'm going to show you one more emulator. This is the Nintendo 64. For this, you'll need a program called 64ce. While it works, it lags a little bit on the G4 system I'm using. I'm sure a higher-end G5 or Intel-based Mac would work far better.
So, do you like my Space Invader shirt? Seriously though, I mean, I showed you a lot of emulators, but I really just kind of scratched the surface. There are so many more other systems out there that you could emulate, and I just didn't have time to show them all to you. And I have a fairly big collection. Here's another one of my favorites from the 1980s. This is a Tandy Model 102. I always wanted one of these when I was a kid, but I couldn't really afford one because they're like $1,400. But I bought this one off eBay for $50. And you know, this video is actually a little bit of a test. I wanted to kind of test the market, so to speak, and see what kind of interest there would be in possibly creating another YouTube channel for retro gaming. I don't know what I would call it just yet, but I'd basically be showing you all the different games from the 1980s and showing you what they looked like on the Commodore 64 and then the Apple II and the Mac and, you know, so on and so forth, and delve a little bit deeper into how to set up some of these emulators and get them working and spend a lot more time than just blowing through them like I did in this video. So I'm going to be kind of gauging the interest over the next few months on this video, see how many views it gets, and I'll kind of make my decision on whether I want to create another channel for that. Now keep in mind, I already have several channels. A lot of people don't realize that. They send me emails saying, well, when are you going to make another video? Well, what they don't realize is I'm making videos all the time, but I currently have 5 YouTube channels. They're not really related to each other, so you may not necessarily be interested. I have, for example, a channel called Awesome Air Guns, where I talk about things, do reviews on air gun equipment, and show blowing stuff up and stuff like that. And a lot of my computer followers here probably wouldn't be interested in that. I also have a channel on gold and silver and how to do investing and stuff like that. Probably wouldn't be an interest in most of you either. But I think the retro gaming thing does kind of fit in a little bit with what I do here on this channel. And so I'll listen to some of your comments and see if anybody thinks that would be a good idea to start another channel on retro gaming, and see where it goes on that. So drop me a line and tell me what you think.